Okay, so we will see the body projected from top of tower. So for example, I am taking a tower of height h. So this is a tower of height h we are taking. And you are projecting a body right from here, and after some time it reaches the ground. So when the body is projected upwards, it has a speed u, let us say. And we are calculating the displacement along the vertical direction, s by bar we are taking. Let us say, we will take the equation of motion in the vector form. So therefore, s equivalent ut plus half at square, we are taking in vector form. So to understand the displacement, we are saying that this is the initial level and this will be the final level. So the displacement will be in the downward direction. So sy equivalent is just we will take minus h into j cap. Uy means the body is projected upwards, u into j cap plus half acceleration into y means minus g into j cap into t square. So after taking the respective sign conventions, if we cancel the j cap, we get minus h equivalent to ut minus half g t square, or we will get h is equivalent to minus ut plus half g t square. So this is the equation we require to solve the problems related to the body projected from top of a tower. And for our convenience, we are slowly modifying this formula into the respective discussion as h is equivalent to minus ui into t, minus ui into t plus half gt square we are taking. So simply you're writing u in terms of ui. So this is the simple way to correlate the motion in a straight line with the motion in a plane. So if we study all the parameters instead of u as uy, so then we will come to know the formulas of motion in a plane also. So that we are going to see right now. So same, we are taking the body projected from the top of a tower, but obliquely. Body obliquely projected. Obliquely projected up from the top of tower. Up from the top of tower. So we are taking, for example, this is a tower. And from the tower, you are projecting a body with a speed u at an angle theta. So in this case, we will take uy equivalent to u sine theta, uy equivalent to u sine theta, and the displacement sy is equivalent to uy into t plus half ay into t square. Or we will use the above formula, h is equivalent to minus uy into t plus half gt square. So then we will write h is equivalent to minus u sine theta t minus u sine theta t plus half g t square. So this is the equation we will use when the body is projected up obliquely from the tower of height. For example, this is a tower of height h. This is a tower of height h. Actually, here. So after that, we will take body projected downwards. We will think of the body projected downwards. Similarly, I am taking body projected downwards from the tower of height h. From the tower of height. For example, you are throwing a body in the downward direction. Suppose if you are throwing the body in the downward direction, uy, let us say, the displacement is h. So we will write h is equivalent to uyt or ut plus half a by t into t square. Or simply we will understood the this as h is equivalent to u by t plus half a y means half g t square. Or simply as the body is vertically projected, we will write h is equivalent to u t plus half g t square. H is equivalent to u t plus half g t square we are taking. So this is the equation we require. So similarly, we will approach for the body projected obliquely. Suppose I am taking the body projected obliquely from the top of tower. Body projected obliquely from the top of tower in the downward direction. So downwards we are taking. For example, so this is a body projected obliquely from the tower. For example, this angle is theta and this body is projected with a velocity u. So now we will take, just we will use h is equivalent to u y into t plus half g t square. Our h equivalent to, we are writing u sine theta t plus half g t square. So in this way, we will understand about the body projected obliquely from downwards. Body projected obliquely from downwards. Simply we will use u y is nothing but u sin theta known to us, and the body is projected as the body is projected downwards. The body projected downwards means this, you need to correct the diagram. So in this way we are projecting, this is the body u, this will be u cos theta, and this will be u sin theta. This will be u sin theta. So in this way we will project the body downwards. So after taking this, we will think of horizontal projectile. So we will think of horizontal projectile. So when we think of horizontal projectile, so let us see. For example, I am taking this, and this is a body. This is a body. So it is projected horizontally. It is projected horizontally. Suppose now this is projected with a speed. Now let us say this is projected with a speed u. Now this is projected horizontally with a speed u. And as usual, we will discuss some points. Let us say this is the point A, and this is the point B, and this is the point C. So we will see A is nothing but we will call A is nothing but point of projection. A we will call it as point of projection. And we will take B. B is nothing but this is a point after some time t. Point after some time t. B is a point after some time t. And this will be the C. C is nothing but a point of striking. Point of projection. For example, first we will think of a point of projection A. At A, we are thinking at point of projection. At point of projection. So at point of projection, we will see that ux is equivalent to u. So as the body is projected horizontally, as the body is projected horizontally, dy dx is equal to u and uy equivalent to 0. And ax equivalent to 0 and ay equivalent to plus z we are having. Ux equivalent to u and uy equivalent to 0. Ax is equivalent to 0 and ay equivalent to plus z we are taking. So here we have the total energy. So total energy at A. So we have both potential energy and as well as kinetic energy we have. So potential energy is nothing but let us say this height is h. So therefore mgh, and as well as kinetic energy is nothing but half mu square we are writing. So these are the parameters that we require at the point of projection. So then we will think of the point B after some time t. So after some time t, after some time t. So after some time t, the point, we are at the point B. We are at the point B. For example, this is the tower. You are projecting the body horizontally, like this. You are projecting the body. So this is the situation, point B. So now you are taking the vector representation for the point B. Suppose this tangential direction represents the velocity, and this will be the Vx, and this will be the Vy. And the body covers x distance along x-axis and y distance along x. So first we will think of the velocity vector. First I am writing Vx is equivalent to Ux plus Ax into t. So Vx equivalent to horizontal velocity is u and the x component the acceleration is 0 and into t. So Vx is equivalent to u. And Vy equivalent to Uy plus Ay into t. So Uy means it is 0. Suppose if you are understanding the scenario in 2D, so we will take g into downwards means minus j cap. Or if you are interested to represent the same situation in the 3D, instead of j, we will take k. So Vy equivalent to minus g into j cap into t. Suppose we will write the vector form. If you are interested to write the vector form, we will write dx into u. And if we write the vector form, we will write u by bar. So final velocity vector is nothing but Vx into I cap plus Vy into J cap. So that equivalent to U into I cap minus Gt into J cap. For example, if the velocity vector, makes an angle alpha, the velocity vector makes an angle alpha. For example, if the velocity vector makes an angle alpha with the x-axis, the velocity vector makes an angle alpha with the x-axis. So simply we will write tan alpha is equivalent to Vy by Vx. So tan alpha equivalent to Vy by Vx. So tan alpha equivalent to Vy. Vy means in the vertical direction, just I'm taking the magnitude here. So Vy equivalent to Gt by u you are taking. And after that, we will take the horizontal displacement and as well as vertical displacement after some time. So first I will take horizontal displacement. Horizontal displacement x we are taking. So we know that distance covered along x-axis is Ux into t plus half Ax into t square. So this is x and Ux is u into t plus this will be 0. So x is equivalent to ut we have. So this is an equation. Or else we will get t is equivalent to x by u. Suppose if you need the vertical displacement. So vertical displacement. So we are taking it as y. Vertical displacement, we are taking it as y. So Sy is equivalent to Uy into t plus half Ay into t square. So vertical displacement means we will take y equivalent to, so as the body is moving downward, as the body is moving horizontally, Uy is 0 plus half into g into t square. We are right. Or simply we will write y equivalent to half gt square. Y equivalent to half gt square. And y equivalent to g by 2 into t means we will write x by u whole square. So that equivalent to g by 2u square into x square. Y equivalent to g by 2u square into x square u will get. Okay. So after this, so y is proportional to x square means the path of a projectile, this horizontal projectile is parabola. So after that, we will think of point of striking. So this is point of striking C. So point of striking C. So now we will think of the point of striking C. For example, this is the tower. And you are projecting a body. You are projecting a body horizontally so that it reaches the point of striking here. So now it has velocity v in this direction, and this is vx and as well as theta. So let us say it makes an angle beta right here. So vx is always equivalent to ux, that is nothing but u because ax is equal to 0. And Vy is nothing but just we will write g into t, where t is time of flight. T is time of flight. So as the body, or we will write V square minus V square equal to 2S. Like this, we will write V equivalent to root of 2Vx. Suppose V bar is equivalent to, we will write Vx I cap plus Vy into J cap.
Sir.
V bar equivalent to Vx into I cap plus Vy into minus A cap. So after taking the velocity, we think of time of flight, time taken by the body in, to remain in A. So the time taken is, let us say, capital T, and the vertical displacement is H. So therefore, T equivalent to root of 2H by G. So that means in the vertical sense, it is equivalent to freely falling body. And next we will think of the range, the horizontal range. Horizontal range R we are taking. So when we think of horizontal range capital R, for example, this is the oblique projectile. Suppose this will be the range R. This will be the range R. So we know that Sx is equivalent to Ux into T plus half Ax into T square. So according to the oblique projectile already we studied, the range means always the horizontal displacement. So let us say this is R. Ux is nothing but U. And the time taken is t, that equal to 0. So therefore, r equivalent to u into root of 2h by g. So this range, capital R equivalent to u into root of 2h by g. So in this way, we will understand the range. So after that, suppose at the point of striking, at point of striking. If the body makes an angle beta, with respect to horizontal, then for example, this is the tower and the body projected horizontally like this, and it makes, with respect to the ground, it makes an angle. This is the ground, this will be the velocity, this will be the beta. So tan beta, only I'm writing the magnitude, tan beta equivalent to Vy by Vx. So that is Gt by U. Or we will write it as root of 2 Gh by U. And after this, we will take up some application. We will take care of some applications of the horizontal projectile. So first one is line of sight. For example, I'm taking, this is a tower. This is a tower of height h. And this is the body projected horizontally, and this horizontal body reaches the point here. And this distance will be the same. For example, if you're trying to construct a line from the point of projection to the point of striking, and this line is called as line of sight. This is called as line of sight. So let us say it makes an angle theta. So then we will write simply tan theta equivalent to h by r, where theta is the angle made by line of sight with respect to the horizontal. So tan theta equal to h by range means we will write u into root of 2h by u into root of 2h by, so that equivalent to h by u into root of g by 2h. Or we will take this h inside also. So this is one of the application of horizontal projectile. So we will take the second application. So we have two parallel streams. They are separated by a distance. And we have a bullet. That bullet is penetrating, and it was passing through two parallel streams which are separated by the distance and making two holes. So it makes two holes. Let us say these two parallel streams are A and B. So these holes are separated by a vertical displacement h, let us say. So when we think of that, the bullet comes in this way and making a hole at A. And because of gravity, it may take a path which is similar to the horizontal projectile. And again, it will make a hole and it will comes out like this. So then they will ask about the value of h. So simply, this bullet passing through two parallel streams is also treated as the application of horizontal projectile. So therefore, we will take r equal to u into root of h. So range is nothing but d. D equivalent to u into root of 2h. So 2 into h means we are taking that h as small h. So we have this kind of application. Range d equivalent to u into root of 2h. So after taking this, we have some clips related. So we have two clips, A and B, let us say. They are at heights H1 and H2 from the ground level. And we have a car which is traveling from A to B. So let us say we have a car. So that is traveling from A to B. And the car is moving with a speed U, let us say. So this is also treated as the application of horizontal projectile. So let us say the distance between the two clips is D. So same as usual, you are taking R equivalent to U into root of 2H by G. The range is nothing but D. And this is equivalent to U into root of 2 by G into H1 minus H2. H1 minus H2. So this is the situation. So where you are taking the applications of horizontal projectile. And also, we have some applications like this. For example, we have a tower of height. And we are taking two horizontal projectile. So one is propagating in this way and the other is propagating in its opposite direction. You are projecting with speed, let us say this is U1 and this will be the U2. And the velocity vectors, let us say this is V1 bar. V1 bar and this will be the V2 bar. So after some time, these are the velocities. They make an angle theta. So that means you are projecting two projectiles horizontally with speeds U1 and U2 in opposite directions. They used to move away from the tower. And after some time t, their velocity vectors makes an angle theta. So therefore I'm writing the time taken by the two bodies. The time taken by the two bodies to make an angle theta between their velocity vectors. Between the velocity vectors. So we have a shortcut t equivalent to root of u1 u2 by g into cos theta by 2. So during this time, the relative separation between the bodies. During this time, the relative separation between the bodies. So as the bodies are moving in opposite direction, we will take relative velocity into time. So that relative velocity is u1 plus u2 into t. So the t, just now we have seen, root of u1 u2 by g into cot of theta by 2. So this is the relative separation between the two blocks. So this is very important in the case of horizontal projectile applications. For example, this is a tower. This is a tower of height H again, the same story we are taking. So you are projecting two bodies with some speed U1. And this is another different speed. Now we require the condition for the displacement vectors makes an angle theta. So this is one displacement vector and this will be the another displacement vector. So let us say this is S1 and this will be the S2. So we have an angle theta between them. So therefore, so T equivalent to 2 into root of U1 U2 by G into cot theta by 2. So the relation, the relative separation, the relative separation between two bodies during the above time. So this will be the relative separation during the above time. SR is equivalent to UR into SR means that is U1 plus U2 into. So time means about time we will use. So this is the way to understand the horizontal projection.